If you're streaming on Twitch, then you already know there's a ton of cool stuff that you can add to your stream. But for some reason, 99% of streamers don't use these free Twitch extensions to massively help their channels.
The heck is going on with that?
These Twitch extensions will help you get more viewers, make more money, and get more followers. And who doesn't want those?
I know my greedy little butt wants all three.
So in this video, I'll show you 6 free Twitch extensions that I use in every stream.
And the last extension is honestly a game changer,
and it's so freaking simple, yet so effective.
Coming in hot at number 1 is going to be the Streamlabs Stream Schedule and Countdown. It is a little widget that you put as a panel underneath your stream. So let's go check out my channel. We'll just go to the top right corner, hit channel. Then we'll go to the chat option or about, doesn't matter. Scroll down and you will see right here we have the Streamlabs Stream Schedule and Countdown. And the neat thing about this is that you just simply put your stream schedule in here and it will automatically convert it to your viewer's time zone from wherever they're watching. So all I got to put is that I stream every Monday at 7 p.m. Central, and whatever viewer is looking at this in their time zone, it will automatically be converted with a live countdown until our next stream. And I find this to be super useful in getting more viewers because they actually know when I'm going to be live next, as opposed to just looking at my offline banner where they have to do actual math. And actual math is scary, especially if you talk to anyone on TikTok because they can't do math. Yes, that includes myself before you roast me in the comments. I am not an exception. Even though your teacher's like, oh, well, you're not going to have a calculator in your pocket all the time. And all you gotta do to set this up for your stream is go to the extensions tab, which is found under the creator dashboard in the top right corner. You go to the left-hand side that says extensions, and then you're gonna search for Streamlabs. Enter, and you're gonna find the Streamlabs stream schedule and countdown. You're gonna add that to your channel, and you're gonna add that as a panel. Then you can configure it with this little configure button. You're gonna have to use army time, which I know is scary for a lot of people, including myself. Just add 12 to whatever number that you have if it's in PM, otherwise just keep it in the first 12 if it's in AM. It's that simple. The one thing that annoys me about this plugin is that it doesn't handle daylight savings time very well. After daylight savings time, if we spring forward an hour or if we go back an hour, come back into here after it's happened and then just resave your settings. Otherwise, it's going to be about an hour off. So Streamlabs, hopefully, can you fix that, please? Because it's really annoying. But other than that, I like it. So just put in your schedule here and then hit save settings. Then just go back to your extensions tab. You can click on my extensions and you'll be able to add it as a panel under here. Moving on to number 2, which is a really popular one, is the Blerp sound effects extension. You can find it. Well, it's right here under a featured extension. So that's pretty cool. But if you don't see it there, just type in Blerp, enter, click on here. But essentially what this will do is you can also add it as a panel just like we did for the Streamlabs countdown, and you can add different sound effects that are already in the Blerp library, which has like thousands of different ones to choose from. And you can set it to use your channel points. You can integrate it with your channel points so your viewers can go and use their channel points to play these different Blerp sound effects for free. And you can also integrate bits if you're an affiliate, so that way you can make a little bit of extra money on the side while your viewers get more engagement. So Blerp is really diverse in the fact that you can use it both for channel points and for bits. And you can also set it up so certain individuals like your subs, you can use a free sound effect as a walk-on every time you start your stream. So there's a lot of stuff that you can do with it. Extension number 3 is going to be crowd control. Crowd control is one of the best ways to mix viewer engagement and making some extra money on the side, just like Blerp. But I would argue that it's even more effective, because what crowd control does is it allows viewers to spend bits in order to actually modify things that are going on in your game. So if you're playing Super Mario 64, they can remove all your health, they can give you fly caps, they can make you Metal Mario, they can do pretty much anything using their bits. So you make some extra money and chat gets engaged, and you just create really funny content overall. You'll find this one also usually under the featured extension because it's just a straight banger. Otherwise, you can just type in crowd control into the search bar here and it's going to be the first one and you'll see it here. And like the Blerp extension, this one is pretty complex, especially because you need additional software to make this work, because it will integrate with your actual game that you're playing. So you'll have to use their crowd control app in order to integrate everything. But luckily, they have some pretty decent guides on their website, and they have over 100 games that are supported. And it looks like now you can use channel points for crowd control coins as well, instead of just doing bits. So it looks like you have more engagement options if you choose to use the channel points as well. But I'm a greedy little MFer, so usually I just keep it to bits. But I digress. Moving on to extension number 4. Technically, this is not an extension, but it is a built-in feature through Twitch. And I already know there's going to be one person in the comments like, well, Cody, you know
that's not actually an extension, right?
Shut up. I bet you were the kid in school that when the bell rang, you reminded the teacher to collect the homework, and everybody got pissed off at you. So don't be that guy. So number four is using the built-in goals through Twitch. You can find those in the Stream Manager tab in your creator dashboard. You'll just go to your Quick Actions tab here, and you'll add a little plus button, and you'll see one that says Manage Goals under Grow Your Community here. So you'll add that, and then you'll simply click the button here, and you'll be able to add a follower goal if you're not a Twitch affiliate, or you'll be able to add a subscription goal, or you'll be able to add pretty much any ones that you want. And the reason why I like these a lot, since they're built into Twitch, when you have these goals set up, you can go to your actual channel and they'll be featured directly under your stream, which plays animations and different effects like right here, so people can actively see your goals versus just having them on your screen. And I like these a lot more because they'll also cast like different chat banners that go above your chat that animate saying like, oh, we're halfway there to the goal, or oh, we smashed the goal, and it will do a bunch of cool crazy stuff that normal goals will not. So I found that using the built-in goals on Twitch are a great way to increase your followers and your subs simply just because they're built in and they have way more features than your typical goal does. So make sure to use these in your stream. Moving to number five, we have a pretty controversial one, but it is timeout with bits. Luckily, my chat is full of buttholes, so they love it. You'll find this one if you go to the search bar and type in timeout, and you're gonna see timeout with bits. So this one is cool because you can actually have your chatters time each other out by using their bits. And it's actually really simple. I have mine set as a component, and viewers will literally just be able to pay a certain amount of bits to time out another chatter for X amount of time. And if you click on the configure button here, you'll be able to adjust all of your different timeout options that you can set. You can choose if VIPs or subs deserve to be timed out. You can also add different messages. You can add alerts, theme customization. You got a bunch of stuff. But if you got a chat that's a little bit spicy, this is a great one for you because once again, it adds more engagement because people kind of use it against each other, and also puts a little extra coin in your pocket so you can buy a McChicken for your next lunch. I heard they brought back the spicy McChicken. I actually really like that one. I don't know why they took it away in the first place though. That was a dumb move. But just know that this extension comes with great responsibility because it has great power. You don't want your chat getting too pissed off, so make sure that the amounts are set appropriately. You don't want to have too long a timeouts, otherwise someone that's getting absolutely dogged on and bullied, they might leave if they don't have a good sense of humor. So set them accordingly. You know your community better than anyone else, so you'll know what to do. Which brings us to my favorite extension, which is a game changer and so simple yet so gosh darn effective. And that's going to be the Prime Gaming Benefits Reminder. You'll find it if you just type in Prime in the search bar and it says Prime Gaming Benefits Reminder. This thing is so freaking simple yet so amazing. What happens is basically you'll add this as an overlay. So you go to My Extensions, add it as an overlay. Literally a viewer will just have to hover their mouse over your screen. They'll see a little claim your sub button. And if they have not used their free Twitch Prime sub, which literally 90% of people forget to use every month, they click this button and they can use their Prime sub on you with literally the click of a button, which is insane. I've gotten so many Prime subs from people that have forgotten to use it because this is a simple reminder and you don't have to do anything crazy. You literally just click the button and they get to use the free Prime sub on you. It's literally stupid simple and so effective. I've made a good amount of money just from this little Prime reminder. And the setup is stupid easy too. Just hit configure. You can choose to set it as a component or an overlay. I like to use it as an overlay because it automatically goes over the screen instead of them having to click on the side. So I feel like it's more useful. And then once you do it as an overlay, you can pick if it goes in the top right corner, top left, bottom right, or top middle. And it's literally that easy. And if you want to take your stream to the next level, then you can watch this video to the side of me because I'm going to give you even more tips and tricks. But my name's Cody, and I will see you in the next one.